PowerDirector 16 tutorial on how to create custom color boards. That's what we're going to talk about in this PowerDirector tutorial. You will notice I have my color boards up here, but I'm going to click here and show you what you're probably going to see. When you first load PowerDirector 16, you're going to put your media content in here by clicking this here. But what you're not seeing is the other options that you have. I can use the drop-down box to select color boards, backgrounds, my projects, express projects, or I can click this arrow and pull this out, and then I can get the same selection here. So then I can actually get my color boards that you'll see there. Now up here with the plus sign, you'll see where it says create a new color board. So we're going to click that, and I'm going to go from color selector. It's going to give us a large selection of different colors that we can use. Now I can just click in here, move this around to whatever I want. And notice I put a color down there. I could click this here, and that'll change the color there. You'll also notice where it says red, green, blue. In a lot of other programs, you can pull those numbers. It'll usually be sitting in like a paint program, and you can just type them in and get your color to match whatever you're working on. So let's say, for example, I want this particular yellow, and I say OK. It jumped right in, and it left it right there. So now I've got a custom color that is totally different than the rest. If I want to delete the custom color, I simply right-click. That will allow me to remove it. Or I can insert it into my track. And you'll notice where it put it there. So now I can drag that pretty much anywhere I want it to go. At the same time, if you choose, after you've made it, you can right-click it and change alias. They probably should have put change name to make it much more user-friendly on people, but if you click change alias, then you can rename the color. Instead of having the numbers, go down to the bottom and you'll see where it has your custom color sitting there for when you want to use it on your next project. This is how you will create a custom color inside PowerDirector 16. If you want to know how to use these color boards with your actual text, I have a video already made for that. I'll link it up at the top for you guys. It'll also be in the description box. And this has been a tutorial on PowerDirector 16 on how to do custom color boards. Are you into prepping? Then you might want to check out Admiral Preparedness. He has videos on how to store food and just general conversation, even recipes on in case something happens. Are you prepared if a tornado hits or a hurricane or a flood? If not, you might want to head over to Admiral Preparedness and check out some of his videos. At any rate, I'll catch you guys on the next one.